Stasera siamo poche persone in un piccolo angolino della città vecchia di Sanremo, ma quello che i ragazzi fra qualche minuto ci mostreranno, a mio avviso, è qualcosa di magico, di molto diverso da quello che si vede nelle scuole. Non sono venuti dalla Svezia, dagli Stati Uniti e da varie regioni italiane per imparare niente. Non c'era nulla di preconfezionato, al contrario, sono venuti questi 10 giovani per creare tra di loro un bellissimo gruppo di lavoro, esprimere le idee per la musica, per creare delle trame e assieme a delle persone esperte hanno creato un piccolo musical. Fra 24-48 ore tutti questi giovani saranno rientrati, chi in Sicilia, chi in Piemonte, chi in Florida, chi a Malmö, in Svezia. Sicuramente sarà nata una bellissima amicizia che durerà per gli anni. Ma una cosa che io sono sicuro per molti anni li accompagnerà, se non per tutta la vita, sarà l'autostima, la fiducia nelle loro capacità. Una fiducia che spesso la scuola non alimenta e che non riconosce. E in queste mie parole naturalmente c'è anche un risentimento chiaro nei confronti di un'istituzione che tende a insegnare e non a coltivare, ad alimentare, ad accendere per tutta la vita. Un breve ma sentito ringraziamento a Cassie Spangler, che 3 anni fa era una semplice tutor che lavorava ai nostri City Camps in Italia, che ha voluto presentarmi suo papà David Spangler, che è un esperto di teatro musicale che insegna in una università della Florida e che è venuto 2 anni fa a Baiardo e che in questo piccolo villaggio, in questo piccolo paese, ha scoperto delle grandi potenzialità, per cui le parole ricorrenti sono: l'anno prossimo saremo molto più numerosi. Un grazie al Comune di Sanremo che ci ha offerto lo spazio e poi alle persone che hanno contribuito a dare vita assieme ai 10 ragazzi, e le persone sono molto numerose, sono quasi uno a uno, e questo è bene anche per i genitori che sappiano quanto è stato l'impegno da parte di Lovewell, la fondazione americana, e ACLE, l'associazione italiana, per sostenere in questi pochi giorni lo sforzo creativo dei ragazzi. E queste persone sono, cerco di ricordarmeli tutti, sono innanzitutto Cassie e David, il musicista Michael, Romina Tappi, Sara la coreografa, ma poi anche Iva e Luca, Chasim, che si sono dati da fare. Chi altro? Sapevo che c'era qualcuno, l'anima che dall'ufficio si relazionava sempre con questi creativi. Lascio, e I'm sorry if I spoke just in Italian, I know there are some of you that would like to know what I've said, but I think Cassie will now continue and tell you how she felt the experience went. Thank you, Cassie.
Thank you. Well, I think Arrigo pretty much covered it all. We're so grateful to be here. Thank you to all of you for being here. This is our first year doing a Lovewell program here in Italy. We've done programs in Florida, in New York, in LA, in Sweden, in Russia. So it's just a dream come true to have gotten the opportunity to do this here in Sweden. In Italy. Where am I again? It's been a very long day for us. So thank you so much for being here. Thank you to all of our staff. Michael, We couldn't have done it without Michael, our wonderful music director. Or Luca, our wonderful assistant music director, and our cook. He made lunch for us every day. David, who is my father and also was a wonderful creative advisor on the project. As we mentioned, Alice, Sara, our amazing choreographer. Jasim, who was here to help us through all of the everything that we encountered up in Bayardo. We've had a beautiful 2 weeks in Bayardo. When we started on day one, not a single word of this show existed. Every idea, every lyric, every melody, every dance came from the students and staff of this program. So this is our first time breathing life into this project that these students worked on. So I'm so grateful to all of you for being here. I think that's... And thank you to Romina. Romina is a saint of all saints. She has opened her heart to us, opened her her lovely bar down the street to us, which has been a sanctuary for the students in this very hot weather here. We could not have done it without her. And it's all just out of the kindness of her heart. So really, truly, we couldn't have done it without her. I think that just about covers it. Without further ado, I would like to introduce One Shot, a new musical.
Outside my doorstep, the air is Should we fight? Should we hide? We must keep searching.
Thank you. I was so worried about you.
I'm so happy to see you again.
You look so tired.
Yes, we traveled for a day.
Wait here, I will call my mom.
Mom, my friend needs your help. Look, Annie, she used to go to my school. She's with a few others from the north.
Their town soon will be occupied by the dictator's army.
I haven't seen you for years. What are you doing here?
You know the situation. I'll tell you now to be occupied any day now.
We need somewhere to hide.
Please, Mom, we have to help them.
Wait, I have to talk to your aunt. Listen, we have a bit of a situation. These are friends of Helen's from the north, and we need somewhere to stay. What do we do?
What kind of question is that? We have room in the basement. Of course they can stay here.
But we can't keep them. It's too risky. If someone finds out, we're all dead.
If we say no, they're dead. Have you forgotten what this dictator and his men have done to my brother?
Of course not. I remember it every day. He was the love of my life.
I will help you to keep them safe, Mom. Please, we have to help our family.
I agree. This is the only safe place for them to stay. It's what he would have wanted.
Of course we have a room. Welcome to Hotel Philippot.
Thank you. Follow me down to the basement. You must be tired from all that traveling.
Finally, we have a safe place to stay.
For now.
I was so worried.
Yes, my family decided to find a safe place to stay. We are all separated and fighting. I hope my family is okay. I'm so happy to see you again. So, it's wonderful.
What exactly happened to you guys?
Well, we all live in the north, near the border. The dictator and his army are occupying the towns one by one. And he will soon arrive to our home.
Some friend will be coming to help us in a few days.
I know we'll see the sun again soon.
That's a spirit. What's your name, by the way?
I'm Sophie.
And how old are you?
I'm 12.
Well, nice to meet you, Sophie. And that's right. You'll be safe here from all that fighting. I'd love to give that idiot dictator a few punches in the face. Hello?
Hi, Anne.
Yeah, they just need some rest. They're settling in all right. Okay? Yeah, all right. Helen, your mother needs me upstairs. If you guys need anything, please let me know. You stay here for now.
Something. And aren't
there supposed to be more of you?
Well, your stupid show is wrong. We're not running from anything.
Maybe you're right. We were supposed to have lobster for dinner the other night, but we didn't. But life goes on. Nona Rose, are you okay? Two dark ravens will soon descend upon this nest.
What?
It's probably nothing. I have to be going now. Please, enjoy your stay.
Did anyone else hear that? About the two ravens?
Don't worry.
She's just a crazy old lady.
Yeah, I don't think she can really see the future.
But then how did we know that? How did she know we were down here?
We have more important things to worry about now.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Sophie, you are okay?
How long have you had the cup?
A couple of weeks, maybe? I don't remember.
Let's get in bed. You need some rest.
Is she going to be okay?
I don't know.
I hope so.
Look at us, darling. Together we are amazing. We conquered the last three rebel outposts in the south. And all before lunchtime!
I was skeptical at first, but in the end we did it. But why must we leave the encampment? I'm so tired of the crowd.
I want to sleep in a comfortable bed tonight. Tomorrow is an important day. I don't want to be rested.
Yes, you're right. Tomorrow we will finally move into the Northern Territory. But where we could sleep?
I know a place near here. Follow me. But I want to stay with you. What do you think?
I don't know. Maybe one room would be better.
Now there's all sorts of people here. Refugees, families, children, all these people who live in fear. But never in my wildest dreams could I imagine their futures in my head. Futures in my head. Let me show you to your room.
We're going to be stuck in this basement forever.
I have a cousin that you were in Nelson. We could find a way to get to him without the dictator finding us. Then we can stay there for a while. We will finally be free.
It doesn't matter who is in neighboring nation. We still have to get past the border. It's impossible.
Maybe we can...
No, I already thought of that.
Do we know anyone else who could help us?
No. No one was worried still as for us. Why should they?
So, what do we do?
There's nothing we can do. I already told you, we're stuck.
There's always something we can do. We've come so far. Don't give up yet. Can't you see it? A place that we call home. Where we're not alone. Just listen. Imagine it. A home where we'll be free. A home where we can be a family.
Thank you.
We wanted to pay a visit.
Emmy! Helen! Are you guys okay? Do you have enough food?
Yes, thank you. We have some very important news for you.
Is your friend alright?
I don't know. She has been coughing like this for a week.
Is there a way to see a doctor?
No, that's just it. You can't leave.
Not even to see a doctor. This won't take very long.
I'm alright.
Can she sneak out at night to get treatment?
The dictator's army is everywhere, and they can see everything. Every corner, every door, every entrance, and every exit.
And why are there troops everywhere? I thought this was neutral territory.
It is neutral territory, but he's here.
Who's here?
Only a dictator will travel with so many guards by his side. He is here?
Yes, in the hotel.
That's the raven descending on the nest.
Huh?
Last time you were here, Sheldon said that two dark ravens would descend upon our nest. Sheldon was right.
Oh, I guess he was.
This can be happening.
It's true, he's here. I saw him with my own eyes.
Because he has made him kill me. He will never forget my face.
Why? What happened?
Dark room, eyes meet. One shot, one shot, one shot.
She's right. A few years ago, I was so close to end this range completely. We were in the same room. He saw me. I had one shot, and I missed. I'm so sorry, we can't leave this room. I didn't mean to put you in danger.
As long as we stay down here, we're safe.
Nobody's safe now!
You don't have to shout like that.
But nobody listens to me if I don't shout.
I always listen to you.
But you don't hear me.
I hear you better when you don't shout.
You do?
Finally! I want my hot water.
Hot water, sir. Hot water.
What are you saying? You think I'm a fool?
Apologize to her.
My assistant is very, very, very sorry.
It's no problem. Do you need anything else?
Yes, I want...
No thanks. We don't need anything else. You can eat. If you're going to be a great leader, you must control to live. You must learn to control yourself.
It's not about controlling myself. It's about controlling the whole world.
Alexander, you're not a boy anymore. This is not a game.
It's all a game.
Alex, I know you. I've known you for so many years. You're smart. You are brave. You are a good leader.
I used to think I was a good leader, but now I don't know. I'm so angry now, all of the time. I wish I have all the answers.
No one has all the answers. How do you want history to remember you?
I don't know.
I think that the good guy always wins in the end.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
Last time I saw your face, there were soldiers marching, people dying, children running, mothers crying, my husband helping those who needed help. And he was gone without a trace, but never in my wildest dreams could I imagine him killed outside my door.
Peter's room. And as I left, I heard him talking to his assistant. He was talking about changing his ways, becoming less angry at the world. I guess that she has known him for a long time because she saw him in another light. He seemed so sad and confused.
What's so interesting about that?
I don't know. I've never really seen him as a person. I've always felt that he was pure evil.
He's a 100% evil, if you ask me. A man is as fond as Satan.
Maybe he's not an evil person, but just someone who does evil things.
Tell that to my dead brother. Your husband, or the thousands of people he's killed.
We must prepare the food for the others.
Hello, everyone! Where's my coffee?
I'll go get that coffee for you.
What's happening? What is all this food in the box?
It's nothing.
Nothing? There must be an explanation. Is it for a party?
Yes, a surprise party for you.
That's strange, but you know, I love parties.
Let's go get the coffee.
That was close.
I'm getting way too old for this, man.
They must be preparing for my party. But why is my party going to be to the basement? That's the last place I would want my party to be.
So, why couldn't you get to the mansion?
There are guards everywhere. Ever since the dictator arrived. I tried to get past them to find the mine, crazy. But they kept asking me what this was for. I told them I was sick, but they didn't believe me.
You could have tried harder. She's dying here.
I am?
You're gonna be okay, sweetheart. You'll be fine.
Everything will be fine. You're gonna be okay.
Don't lie to her. This is serious, and you're not doing her a favor.
She's just a child. Please.
Exactly. She's a child. Look at what that monster is doing to her.
This is not about him. This is about her. And she's not feeling okay. Everybody be quiet! She's trying to say something.
I'm not afraid. That's right, sweetheart. You're gonna be okay.
Close your eyes, it will be okay. You'll be fine, we will find a way. Think of the dreams you've been dreaming, and know that it's bound to come true.
Even when the world is dark, you can
God.
Thank you.
Chloe!
Please, it's important!
I'll go see who it is. You stay here. Aren't you the woman who lives down the hall? What do you want?
I have something very important to tell you. I followed the daughter of the manager to the basement and I discovered a group of rebels. One of them, a young girl, died because she couldn't escape to see a doctor. And now all of them want to kill the dictator because they think it is his fault. And they want to unite the revolution.
There are rebels in the basement of this hotel?
Yes, and they are very angry.
They could kill us any minute. We must be fast. Thank you for telling me. We will make sure you stay alive. There are rebels in the basement here at the hotel.
What?
Rebel in the basement. The hotel manager has been hiding them. One of them died, so the others are very angry. They want to kill you.
Oh my God. What do we do?
I can't lose you. I won't let them kill you. I love you.
Get my gun. I will kill them all.
Wait. Killing them all doesn't solve this. History will remember you as a martyr. They should all live, but they should all die in here. Let's give them a choice.
I have a solution. Follow me. Kill me when you had the chance. Too bad you missed. And you. You think you can play both sides? You think you can play God? If you want to play God, I'll let you play God. You have only one bullet in this gun. If you kill her, stop the revolution, you, your daughter, and your hotel will be safe. But if you kill, my party will capture your daughter, and my soldier will burn down your town. It's your choice. I have only one shot.
Thank you. Thank you.